It's weigh-in Monday. Well, actually, it's weigh-in Sunday. If you don't know me, I am Caroline, and I am committed to do OMAD. That is one meal a day. And what my days usually look like is a 23-hour fast, and then I eat 1 hour out of every day, and it's usually whatever I want. But normally I do my weigh-in and recap on Mondays, but this week I'm doing it on a Sunday. Why? Because my hubby and I are planning a motorcycle trip, and we're leaving today for a few days. We are going to go explore Indiana. I don't know why. We just feel like it. We usually don't plan our routes. We usually just jump on the motorcycles, and we go, and when we get tired, we stop, we chill, and we relax. So kind of really looking forward to it. We are like nomad. I'm a OMAD nomadder, I guess. So I'm pretty excited about it. If you're wondering what kind of motorcycle I ride, I have a 2001 Indian Chief Centennial. It is the 100-year anniversary bike of Indiana, and it is from the Gilroy era. Love my motorcycle. We are planning our motorcycle trip, and that means I am going to be on the road all day today, which is Sunday, all the way through Tuesday night, what we're planning. So I really didn't feel like packing my scale on the motorcycle, so I decided to jump on in, weigh myself, give you an update on the week a day earlier. Not a problem. So let's get right to it, all right? This is week 10, and this is my week 10 results. So I started the week out weighing 212.8, and this morning I jumped on the scale weighing 212.2. So that is a 0.6 pound loss. I'm okay with that. It's still going down, right? Well, let's take a look at the overall real quick. So overall in 10 weeks, I had started with the weight of 235.4. Currently I'm weighing 212.2. So that means I've had a total loss of 23.2 pounds in 10 weeks. How do I feel about the 0.6 pound loss? Well, I am weighing in a day early, and I tend to lose most of my weight at the very last few days. So I'm not feeling pretty bad. Maybe I would have squeezed in another quarter pound, maybe half pound, who knows, but I'm good with 0.6. But I do feel like my weight loss has slowed down a little bit. Even though I continue to lose weight, I have not hit a plateau. I do not consider this a plateau. So I'm asking myself, how can I really maximize the weight loss? You know, this week I totally have no emotional, no emotions. I'm not feeling moody. I'm not feeling cryy. So that's awesome. I'm not irritable. I'm finally never craving anything. And I really don't get hungry until it's kind of time for my window to open. So with that being said, I'm really not struggling with anything. So I think it's time to move to the next level. And when I talk about moving to the next level, I'm talking about maybe starting to watch what I eat, maybe putting some more nutritional value foods in my meal. So you're probably wondering, what are you eating now anyway? So I decided this week, because I knew I was gonna move into this change. I knew I was going to go to the next level. So I decided to snap some pictures of what I ate this week. So let's take a look. Okay. This is my menu for week 10 for the 6 days. So Monday, my hubby brought this pizza. I ate a slice and a half. I ate leftovers on Tuesday, probably ate another slice and a half on Tuesday. Wasn't really in the mood for pizza on Wednesday. We went out, I got a steak, some waffle fries, and green beans. And then Thursday, yep, we went out again, and I ended up getting a steak kebab on a bed of rice with a salad. Oh, can't forget the margarita. And then Friday, I had a split of half chicken, half steak fajitas. I did eat two tortillas with that. And then on Saturday, I had breaded shrimp and corn on the cob with a side salad. Most of those meals, you know, I had a Diet Coke with them. So when I take a look at what I'm eating, you know, I see some good stuff in there, but I see a lot of carbs that are probably not agreeing with me or fueling my weight loss. And I have a great YouTube friend. If you haven't checked out her page, check out Low Carb Sandra. She is pretty much on the carnivore diet. She makes some amazing recipes. She actually motivates me to cook. Her and Cdub. If you have not checked out Cdub, check him out. He also too, like, he'll do videos of cooking and what he's about to eat. And it's kind of motivating me to cook and motivating me to feed myself a little healthier food. So check out those pages. I'll put the links underneath because they are amazing. And I have to tell you, they really have, I don't even think they realize how much they have helped me get through this first 10 weeks. But anyways, so that's the food I'm eating. This week I am planning on taking out some carbs. And I went with some advice my friend Low Carb Sandra said. And she said, hey, just cut out the breads and the pastas right now. Start there. So that's where I'm going to start. And yep, I am going on vacation, but I'm not even worried about it. I feel so in tune with OMAD that I'm all good. So I cannot wait to report how well I did. I'm going to try to continue snapping the pictures of what I eat. So I know I want to cook at home, but since we're going to be on the road today, you know, Monday, Tuesday, I'm going to probably be 3 days of eating out, but I'm going to really try to eat and eat healthier and make healthier choices. But that's it. That is week 10. I am feeling really great, like as far as energy, as far as like emotions. I'm very happy, feeling good, I feel in tune. So I think it's just time to now go to the next level. You know, now that I'm not dealing with the transition in my body getting balanced out in OMAD, and now I really don't have any challenges when it comes to OMAD. Now it's time to add another challenge and do something for my body that it needs and eat healthier. And I'm going to start by cutting out that bread, that pasta, that rice, you know, the sugar. So I'm working on it, but that's going to be the first level this week. And I can't wait to share with you next week on how that's going. As far as like little things I'm doing, I actually, my daughter was, she had gestational diabetes, so she let me have her blood, you know, her blood sugar tester. And I decided to kind of maybe start tracking that this week when I get back from my trip. I want to start tracking my blood pressure because I've always had issues with blood pressure. I want to start tracking that and report out to it. And just see as far as my overall health, you know, which way I'm trending there and share with you. But that's it for week 10. I'm so excited. Life is so good. If you're struggling with OMAD, I'm telling you, stick it out. It's so worth it. But that's it for me now. And I will see you when I get back from my trip. All right. Bye.